Queen, I'm sure you have heard the words of Ishe Pius. The thing is, the matter is simple. You are not in this picture. We just want to let you know, to fulfill all righteousness. I know you are not a traditionalist. I know you are in the church. But, and you also know that I am the traditional prime minister of this kingdom. You know. Go ahead and follow your church way and let God answer us. But I must not leave the gods out of this. I will worry them. I will go extra length with these, my co-cabinet members, to make sure that whoever was responsible for the death of our king is brought to book. That person will suffer the traditional punishment and whatever it takes. His life will become useless. But I'm not going far with this because what we have at hand is better. It's even greater now. As in the news, a new animal. We need to bury our king before any other thing. Then after the burial, we'll go on our mission. You will see the result. So please, keep attending the church and everything, the way people worship, while we are also to continue to worship our own way. What we want is this. If I turn again, knock up again, Azu, at the end, let us have victory. At this juncture, my queen, please take heart and take good care of yourself. Don't think much, not even at midnight. Take care of yourself, take care of the princess and the prince. If there is any need to contact me, send your guard. I will come at once.
Thank you, Ono.
Oh?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you,
Chief. Take care. Huh? Okay, the Mba. Open at the beginning. The was Mba.
It's just a shock. I can't believe this happened. Esther, my father was murdered. My father was killed in my right in front of me. Esther, the pain, the trauma. I can't just put it behind me. However hard I try, so hard to put it behind, but I can't. The pain is just too much. I have cried, Esther. I have cried. But it's obvious that my father is never going to come back. I have asked God. I've asked God to expose his killers. I've asked God to punish them wherever they are. I'm just waiting for God to answer me.
God will definitely answer you. Trust me, he will. Because he will never allow the sorrowful tears of his children to be in vain. God will definitely answer us. If you. Sorry.
Hello, Frank. Where are you? Abuja. What are you doing in Abuja? And when did you even travel to Abuja? Frank, honestly, you surprised me. I'm telling you. Frank, when I told you that I lost my husband, you couldn't even call to check up on me up until now. Even if my husband offended you, Frank, it shouldn't be enough reason for you not to attend his funeral. That's too bad. Ticket to Dubai. Which Dubai? Now listen to me, Frank. Cancel that ticket. Frank, you heard me. I said, cancel the ticket. Listen to me. Listen. Frank, if you don't cancel that ticket, believe me, I won't forgive you. Frank, you listen to me. I'm your elder sister. If you fail to do what I asked you to do, like I said earlier, I will never forgive you again. I'm telling you, try me and see. Better. I will give you time to think about it, so I'm going to call you back in the next 2 hours, Frank. Very stubborn boy.
How far now? My guy, calm down. Calm down. You did that to go tea. We don't do clean job. As I talk to you now, the king don't go down. My bro, no shaking. They did that to go tea now. What if it's up? No shaking. Everywhere I go, everywhere I go. When you lap, you go package everything. No shaking. I'll deal with you. Everywhere I go. Alright, now no pee. No pee. No pee.
Frank, can you please listen to me? Please, you need to come help your sister. Now listen to me now. Whatever problems or issues you had with my husband, you should know that he's dead. I'm not even against you, you know, not attending my husband's funeral. No, I'm not angry. Please, all I'm saying is, whatever it is that you have in mind against him, in any way he offended you before he died, I just want you to forgive and forget. Frank, all I'm saying is for you to come help. Come and help your sister. Take over my husband's company. Please. You know everything about this company. I mean, you can't be here and I'll go and hire somebody that will come and run down my husband's company. Please, I'm begging. Frank, Frank, I know you are stubborn, but then this is the first time I'm asking you for a favor. Had it been my little prince is grown, I wouldn't have been begging you, but he's still a small boy. Please. Hello, Frank. Papa, I invited you over so that I will tell you what Frank is doing to me. Frank is not behaving well. Oh. Of course, Papa. I have been begging Frank to come take over my late husband's company. And Frank doesn't want to show up. I know too well Frank can run my husband's company properly, because he knows everything about the company. He knows the in and out, the secret about the company. Yet he doesn't want to show up. Papa, you know that Prince is still a small boy.
Yes, I do.
Prince cannot take over his late father's company. My daughter, Princess, is still in school. Yes, both of them are young. Please, help me talk to Frank. Please.
Okay, my daughter. Where is Frank now?
He told me that he's now in Abuja.
Frank in Abuja?
That's what he said.
When did he travel to Abuja and what is he doing there?
Do I even know? I don't know. That was just what he told me, that he's now in Abuja. That he has started work, that he's working with one company that sends him to abroad often. I just don't understand.
Frank, my son. Working in Abuja. And he's always traveling abroad. My daughter, I know my son very well. He cannot travel to Abuja without telling me. I don't believe this story. Please call him for me now.
I didn't believe him too. Papa, take his ring and
good, good, good. Hello, Frank, my son.
Papa, Papa, I can't hear you. What are you saying? Papa, I'm on my way to the airport like this, so I'm not going anywhere. Papa, if you know what that man did to me, if you know what that man did to me, you'll not be telling me all these things.
You listen to me very carefully now.
Now you want me to go back and go manage his company? For what? Papa, I'm not going there. Oh. I'm not going anywhere. Papa, I have another job now. As I'm speaking to you, I'm at Nikon Nuga Hotel, chilling. I'm just waiting for my flight time so that I will go to Dubai, have a meeting there, and then come back to Nigeria. I don't need that nonsense business now. Baba? Baba, I'll call you back, please. I can't hear you. That place is very noisy. No, it's not from my end. It's from your end. Okay, Papa, I've heard what you said there. Eh? I've heard you. Okay. It's all right, Papa, I've heard you.
What did he say? He didn't even say anything.
He said he's coming back tomorrow.
Oh, that's what he told you?
Exactly.
Thank God. Gentlemen from my husband's company, I welcome you.
Thank you.
All right, I called you here to let you know that, first of all, I'm sorry I would have come to the office, but then I'm still in my morning clothes. That's the reason I invited you to, and I'm glad you came.
Sorry.
Having said that, purpose for this little meeting is just to let you know that my younger brother, Frank, will be returning to the company as the new managing director of my late husband's company. So when you go back, I would like you to help pass this message to all the staff for them to cooperate with my brother. Maximum cooperation, that's what I need here. Please. One more thing. Anything that has to do with money, any transaction whatsoever that has to do with money must pass through his office before the transaction will be carried out. Have I made myself clear? Thank you so very much. I'm glad you accepted because you have no choice. Thank you. So that'll be all for now. That's the reason I called you all.
See you guys at work tomorrow. Good. Good.
Very short meeting.
Yeah.
Frank, thank you so much for accepting to help your sister. I mean, it's not easy. I mean, I've been begging you, my brother, because I know you're capable of carrying my husband's company from building it from, you know, nothing to something.
It's nothing, sister. It's nothing. All right, you're welcome. So when are you going back to school?
Monday.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, I cannot just wait to finish with my education so I can come join you in the running of daddy's company. It'll be so much fun.
No, no. Leave the running of the company for the men. Once you're done with school, you practice what you studied, which is law.
No, but uncle, okay? I don't think running a company is a gender thing, you know. I mean, I can offer my service. I'll be more than willing to do that. I mean, my father went through a lot sending me through school, and the least I can do is to give back. It's more like giving back, you know, to the company. I'll be glad, Mommy. Mommy, what do you think?
I think she's right.
Yeah. 100%.
Yeah. You're
I think
actually,
the company needs a lawyer, a good lawyer at that, and I know I'm going to be the best for
course,
myself. So.
Of course. You can always come around the company to see how the company's going.
Mm? Of course.
And if there's a problem, we'll hire you as the company's lawyer.
You don't even have to pay me because I am going to give my all.
We have to pay you. Everybody needs money.
Ah, enough of the argument. Enough. You and your baby sister.
It's all right.
She's highly intelligent.
What type of a brother-in-law is this? He's not far from a prodigal son. He's wicked, so extravagant. Living life is all he wants. Money is your target. You don't care how it comes. You're too greedy and wicked.
He's too greedy and
money is what he thinks of. He's ready to kill for it. He's too greedy and wicked.
He loves money too much.
Money is your target. You don't care how it comes. You're too greedy and wicked.
He's so much in love with money.
Money is what he thinks of. He's ready to kill for it. He's too greedy and wicked.
He's too greedy and wicked.
Money is your and target.
Frank, I came to see you.
Yes, Mr. Man, what is it?
I came to find out if you are the one that wrote this termination letter to me.
Whose signature do you have there?
Your signature, of course, Frank.
So what do you have a problem with? The signature? Or the content of the letter?
Fired? On what basis am I being fired, Frank? What have I done to deserve this?
Mr. Man, we cannot have two captains in one ship. Especially when the smaller captain is a threat to the bigger captain. You're lucky I'm in a very good mood today. I would have framed you up and sent you to jail for a very long time. And by the time you come out, you will realize how not to mess with people.
For real?
Yeah, for real.
Now I get the truth. Frank, are you trying to use me to stand your part also? But let me make it clear to you that this thing you have just did, you will live to regret it. It's a promise.
I've done a lot of wrongs in my life, but I do not regret any. I want you to always know and have it to the back of your head that I, Frank, sacked you with no penny in your pocket.
I know there's nothing I can do about this. Uh-huh. But this is the peak and the height of wickedness where the devil himself dwells.
Mr. Man, get out. You can't do nothing.
I'll leave. Oh. But like I said, you will live to regret it.
Oh.
Sister, what I'm saying in essence is you are your husband's next of kin before he died. And right now, I need you to make me a signatory so I can have easy access to money to run some things in the company, especially contracts. Yes, we have a lot of contracts to run, lots and lots of contracts, and we need money to do that. In your condition, you cannot just leave the house and follow me every time to the bank to sign money. No, it's not nice. So I need you to make me a signatory to the account.
Okay, Frank, like, how many contracts are we talking about here?
While I was in company before your husband sacked me, we had like 18 contracts. Yes, and now I'm back. We have another 7 on top of the 18. And there are lots of contracts to execute now. And these contracts are government contracts, and we need money to run them. We cannot execute them without money. And of course, you know, that's how the company makes money, from these contracts. So we need every contract at hand right now.
Are you serious, Frank?
Yes, I am.
All right.
Very serious.
It's okay. In that case, eh? You have to come out tomorrow. Let me take you to the bank for you to meet our company's account officer. All right. Okay?
All right,
so no you will sign your signature.
It's all right. That's good. That's very good. So that we can put things in place immediately. Sister, the kind of money I'll make for that company, you'll be shocked.
You don't need to say.
I'm telling you.
I trust you 100%, my own brother. Kai! I can't wait. I can't wait.
You know that company is like my company. Eh? I'll do everything to make it stand out. Trust me.
I trust you.
Meanwhile, have you heard from the princess?
Yes. I spoke with her 2 days ago.
Oh, okay. What about the prince?
He's sleeping.
sleep. Big man.
I'm telling you.
It's all right, sister. I have to be on my way now.
Mm? It's okay.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
It's all right.
I am grateful.
Uh-huh.
I am grateful, Frank.
It's all right. Thank you. Don't need to be good, too grateful.
All right. Frank, bye-bye, eh?
It's a deep end. SNDB. I seen look at Karakamichi KJP. It's now exactly 24 market days now since our king died. And we came to complain to you. You now told us to go and come back, that you will consult with the gods and tell us who killed the king.
Exactly.
That is the reason we are here.
Yes. I have consulted the gods, and the gods have spoken.
Good. Ha! Eyes of the gods. So, the gods have spoken. Now, who did they say killed the king? Who did the gods say that killed the king?
Go and ask king's brother-in-law. He knows what happened to the king.
What?
Huh? Ezadib, are you sure you know what you just said now? You do not ask the gods question. Makana mo adasiase.
Nene.
Ezadib, we believe you very well. But what if we ask him and he denies it? What do we do? Leave him and come back. I will tell you people what to do. The fight is for the gods.
Thank you. Hey, brothers.
Go and do what I ask you people to do.
Thank you. Naya, I give you. I have to put you on Twitter. Up Boni Road. You say can handle. What do you do? We shall come out outside and come back later. So what are
they? Thank you. Alupana fundemo. Alupana fundemo. Debona legedana mekene.
anya nwụ na gbara na mekene a sị na mkpakara ya ma ọzọ ma n'ụzọ ya na akpakwuru dị n'ebe ụsa arụrụ arụrụ oruru ogo maga na aga jụọ nụ ọchụ nwa ọkụkụ nwa ada nwa ọkụkụ nwee ngwongwo ọsọ.
Elders, why are you people standing? Please, let's go inside.
It's okay, I'll be. The reason we are here, my queen, is not to sit down. We just as well go straight to the point.
I hope all is well.
All is well. We are here to pass a message from Izem.
My queen.
Instead, we are here on a very important mission, which we must achieve. Our queen, I'm sure you can still remember the message sent by Ezemo to you through us 2 days ago. And we sent a message to your brother, Frank, through you. Where is he now? Because he can't keep us all day here.
I know, I believe he will soon be here. Yes, I passed your message across to him, so hopefully he'll be here soon.
Okay. Sister?
Frank?
What's up?
Good.
What's going on?
He's here.
Oh, good. Good enough. Frank, yeah. We sent for you through your sister, our queen.
Okay.
Frank,
oh, no.
You are aware that Ayugwe is late.
Mm-hmm. I am.
Good. And you are also aware that he was killed by unknown gunmen.
Yes, he was attacked. He was attacked by unknown gunmen.
Good.
God punished them.
On hearing such news, we, the elders of this land, swore never to go in and rest until we unravel the mystery. Mm-hmm. Behind his death,
yes.
Until we fish out those who were instrumental to untimely death of our king.
That's such
true. Brutal death. And you are fully aware that the incident happened after you had a kind of face-off with him, had problem with him, yes, mm-hmm. over his company.
And he was sacked.
Mm-hmm. I don't understand, no.
Just do try to understand. Very important.
Where are you going to with this statement of yours? No, I don't get it. What's the meaning of what you just said?
Now, we proceeded to Ogu Shrine.
Ogu Shrine. Yes.
And after consultations, the chief priest told us to tell you to go and ask you what happened to the king because you are fully aware of everything that led to his death.
I beg your pardon.
What?
Yes. That's what I said. I said, you know, the chief priest said, you know everything that led to the death of Ayugwe. That was actually why we sent for you.
Enough!
Which means he killed him.
What?
Yes.
Now what is all this? What's the meaning of this?
You killed him.
Honestly, my queen, I think you're not getting this thing straight.
Allow me get it now, or you talk to me.
Let me clear you properly. Our oracle is pointing accusing fingers to your brother Frank for everything that happened to the king.
Hey!
Do you now understand?
He killed the king.
What?
Ike Young.
Sister, hold on.
Hold on. You said this to my face.
Sister, relax.
You said that my brother, Frank here, killed my own husband. Oh my goodness. Your oracle is indeed a liar.
What?
Of course you heard me. If not for the respect I have for you people, I would have called my guards to bundle you record men out of this palace. What? Are you insane?
What?
Sister, hold on. Let me talk to this old fool.
Eh?
All right?
Listen.
Now listen good.
I want you all to go back to that your wretched oracle. Tell that oracle to retire. Because other oracles, other places have retired and are destroyed.
They're all retired. Do you get?
Go back and tell your lying oracle to retire. Your oracle is fake.
Hey.
Your own foolish men.
What?
Useless men.
Frank, do you realize what he just said is an abomination?
Shut up. Shut up right now. You are the abomination. All of you. You're all abominations.
What am I even saying? Sister, you're here. I'm going to freaking call the police to come and arrest this man for accusing me wrongly and denting my image. I'm not going to take this.
Frank.
I'm not going to take this.
Enough. It hasn't gotten to that. Let them be.
Okay.
They're old enough.
Oh, but listen to me.
Listen to what?
How dare you think you have the audacity to insult the elders and the oracle?
Imagine.
Ogugu Shrine! Now listen to me. You are in fact demanded to come to Ogugu Shrine and swear. And that is as soon as possible. But then, let me say this. Elders, this battle is for the gods. This battle is for the gods. We are not supposed to fight for the gods. We will fight for himself. Get ready to go there and swear.
Oh no! Enough! It's high time you left the palace.
When I say I will leave in good faith.
Out!
I will leave!
I said out!
Yes, I will leave and we shall come back.
You are walking the elders of the land out of your house?
Nobody, let us go. Go, go, go.
Pirates, let us go.
Get out! How dare you?
Did you just say get out?
Oh God, get out!
Hey!
Do not send for me. Do not dare send for me.
If you point your hand towards the queen again, listen to me. I want to strike the gun. God, my husband, are you insane? Now will you get the hell out of this place?
What kind of nonsense is this? No, but what nonsense is this, sister?
Maybe they're angry at me because I'm the one who's managing the company when I'm not even from this kingdom. They're expecting one of their sons to be the manager, not me.
Why haven't I thought of this? My goodness, you know, when my husband was alive, I'm sure he's used to giving them peanuts all the time. Maybe that's what they're expecting you to do. Rubbish.
Maybe that's all they want for me, but...
It's all right.
Let the kids take care of them.
It's all right. No, it's okay.
Sister, I have to go. I have a lot to do at the office. I just came. I didn't know it was because of this old fools.
Can I imagine my busy brother trying to build my husband's company up and they are here accusing thunder. My dear, it's okay.
Sister, don't worry.
It's all right. Just take good care of yourself.
Okay, sister.
All right, I'll call you back. Princess. To what do I owe this visit?
Okay, so I actually came to let you know that I'll be going back to school, let's say next tomorrow.
All right, that's good.
So I'll be needing some money.
Some money?
Mm-hmm.
And how much are we talking about here?
Let's say like 500,000 naira onward for me to manage.
500 what?
1,000 naira.
For what exactly?
What do you mean for what exactly? I just mentioned now that I'm going back to school. So I definitely need the money for my daily runnings, logistics, like feeding, transport. I mean like literally logistics.
You want to go back to school with 500,000 naira? Are you planning on feeding the entire school or what?
What do you mean?
Times are hard. Very hard. We're all trying to manage. But it's alright, let me see what I can do. So you can go back to school and study. Alright, yeah. Make do with that one.
What is this?
Money, of course.
100,000 naira.
Yeah.
And what am I supposed to do with this?
Go back to school.
This cannot take me back to school, clearly. Because this cannot even buy me my flight ticket back. I mean, so what am I going to be doing with 100,000 naira?
And who told you you're going back to school with a flight?
I beg your pardon?
Yes. When I was your age, I don't take flights. I take buses. Use this money. Go out there, buy a bus ticket, All right? I'm sure to take you back to school.
I am lost. All right? I am not here to beg you for money. I'm not begging you. I'm asking you to give me some money from my father's company. Have you forgotten where you are? This is my father's company, all right? Besides, my father doesn't even give me anything less than a million naira for weekends. So I'm only asking you for 500,000 naira because I'm sensitive to the fact that things are hard or might be like you are saying. So, and you're giving me 100k like I'm some charity case you're trying to help. I don't get it. I don't want to disrespect you, but this cannot work.
Well, this is your father's company. You're right. But your father is no more. I run this company now. Okay? And right now, the company has committed money into so many federal and state contracts. So you see, we don't have any money left. Learn to manage. Cut your coat according to your size. That's what everybody's doing now. So manage that money. I'm sure it can take you back to school.
There's no way I'm touching this money. Thanks for the insult. All right, I am not a charity case.
It's all right, I'll just keep my money. Right.
Mom, I really don't understand what is going on anymore. I don't understand.
You mean you went to Frank's office and begged him for 500,000 and he couldn't even give it to you?
He clearly didn't. He handed me over 100,000 naira, asking me to go by night bus when I complained that the money was not sufficient enough for my flight ticket. He even said when he was my age, he wasn't flying, he was going by road, that I should go by road. Mommy, can you imagine? You needed to have been there to listen to how he talked to me, as if I came to beg him, as if I'm one charity case. That's my father's company, it's my father's money we're talking about. Ever since daddy died, it's been so impossible to get money from that office. I'm struggling, and yet my father has so much, left so much behind.
My brother said you should go by night, boss. My own child. It's all right. Nah. Don't worry about anything. I'll go and look for that money and complete it for you.
I didn't take the money, Mommy. I left the 100K on his office desk.
You left it there?
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't call you back?
No, he didn't. The moment I dropped it, said, oh, thank you. And kept it to himself.
It's all right. I'll go and find out why Frank is behaving like this now to my own child. Hello, bank manager. Yes, good day. All is well, thank you, and work. Please, there is something very important I would like you to do for me now. Yeah, I just need some cash because I would like to dispatch some to my daughter. Yeah, she's doing very well. She's about going back to school. So please, from my husband's company's account, I want you to withdraw like 1 million naira transfer to me in my own private account. Yes, 1 million naira, please. No, I didn't get that. What? My brother? Frank withdrew 4.6 billion. Jesus Christ of Nazareth. When was that, please? Ha! All right, no problem. Thank you for telling me. Thank you. Thank you so much. No problem. Just transfer 1 million naira to my own account.
And I would like you to print out the statement of account, my husband's company statement of account. I beg your pardon. No need of printing out the statement. How much is the balance, please? Hold on, did you say 50 billion or? 50,000 naira. In company's account? Manager, you can't be serious. 50,000 naira. Okay, I'll call you. Is he all right? My husband's company's account, 50,000 naira. And my brother withdrew 4.6 billion. Hey! Be careful,
the king is in trouble.
Frank, it's not this one you bash into my office looking so angry.
What did you do with the large amount of money you removed from the company's account? What?
Is that why you're looking so pissed? Come on, sister. Sit down, let's talk about this.
Frank, that's not an answer to my question.
Well, the answer is simple. I used the money for business.
And what kind of business is that?
Contracts. The only business this company knows how to do best. I told you earlier, we have lots of contracts to execute, both federal and state. Right now, we're about to complete the biggest contract ever of all. 160 duplexes? Oh, yes. We're almost done with that. After which, we'll go into the state contract.
Hold on, Frank. All those things that you just mentioned here now, how much are we looking at?
11 billion naira. Now, how do you like the sound of that?
Hold on. You mean 11 million?
I said 11 billion.
11 billion?
Exactly. So you see, I've been very busy.
Frank, that's huge.
Of course it has to be huge. I'm involved.
Are you serious?
Very serious.
Gracious God, are you for real?
Of course I'm for real.
No, that's nice. I love it.
I know.
Good. I'm happier now. I mean, a bit relieved, you know.
Of course.
But then again, when will you finish the contract? And when will they pay this money? Because I will not lie to you, my brother. My children and I are hungry.
No, that's not going to happen. Your children cannot be hungry. You cannot be hungry. Well, the thing that is, in 6 weeks, the federal government is going to release the first money.
Ordinary 6 weeks?
Yes. So in 6 weeks, this company is going to get paid.
Wow. I'm happy. Thank you, Frank. Thank
you're
you.
Welcome.
So where is accountant? Please, help me tell him to pay in some money into my daughter's account. She seriously needs some money to sort out some things in the school.
That's all right. I'll instruct him to do that right away. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. You see, everything I'm doing is for the betterment of this company. At the end of the day, I will make you proud.
Please. I can't wait. Honestly, I can't.
You have to.
I should be on my way now, Frank.
It's all right, sister. Take care of yourself.
All right, don't forget to tell accountant what I told you. It's very important.
I'll do just that. Have a good day, sis.
You too. All right, then. Take care.
Take care, sister.
Your Majesty, I have decided to come and see you and to let you know that there is a problem. Nobody knows what is going on again in the company. Everybody is complaining. Your brother Frank has pushed everybody behind and doing everything in his own likeness. Nobody understands everything. And if you try to approach him or to ask him one or two questions, he will show you and proudly say that he is in charge.
I mean, you said nobody understands anything, right?
Exactly.
Just like I'm not understanding anything you're saying here. You haven't made any point yet.
Your Majesty, all I'm saying is this. Your brother is now building houses of his own at every corner of this city. While the company's fortune is going down day by day. Nobody understands everything. Nobody understands everything. He's now running the company as one-man show. We, the employers, nobody knows what he's doing. Nobody. Many staff have resigned. Because he's no longer paying them. So I decided to come and let you know.
Admin manager.
Your Majesty.
I know your type too well. Your type is the type that goes about spreading false rumors about people, about innocent people, to be precise. I know your type. Can you stop? All that my brother is doing in my husband's company, I am aware of it. So stop this gossip, you're too big for this. Don't you think so?
Your Majesty, I'm sorry. Since you know everything your brother is doing, what of the unpaid salaries?
Are you insane? Get out. Leave this place!
It's okay. It will never happen again. It's okay. Your Majesty, it will never happen again. It's okay.
Sister.
You're here.
You sent for me.
Of course. Enough! Enough! Please go to the backyard and sweep that place first. Frank.
Yes, sister.
I'm not really happy.
What happened?
Somebody just left here now. The person brought a report against you. The person came to tell me that you have not been doing anything in the company. That in fact, you almost shut all the staff up and kept them in one corner. In fact, almost locked them up in one corner. In other words, what he's trying to say is you do everything on your own. You're leaving them in the dark.
How?
Then I'm now asking why, if that's what you did. And he didn't stop there, he said that all you do now is to buy houses.
What?
That you have refused to pay the staff their salaries. You buy cars, and I'm like, whose car is this?
Well, that's my friend's car. My car developed a fault, so I had to park it at the mechanic and borrow his to run errands today. For real? Who's this person that has been telling you this kind of thing? I don't understand. The same staff are increased their salaries without informing you first? Why would I go building a house without telling you, my darling sister, first? How?
Hold on.
The only salary I owe those staffs is that of this month. And the month is not over yet.
Of course.
So what are you talking about?
Hold on, let me get it. You even increased their salary.
Yes, I did.
Without even telling me. When you're trying to be nice to them, yet this person had the nerve to come and gossip my brother to me. He's even insane.
Sister, who's this person that told you this rubbish? I need to know who this person is, so I can know who to avoid in that office.
Well, let me not lie to you. It's the admin manager, Obiora.
Obiora?
Of course, Obiora. He just left here.
The same fool that came to my office 3 days ago to beg for a loan to start a building project in his village. And I told him the company didn't have that kind of money to spend at the time. That should hold on so I can think about it and then you know when to give him a loan. Maybe next month.
Obiora.
Had the guts to come tell you this.
Oh, he wants a loan to start up a house.
Huh.
You refused?
Yes, I refused.
So that you can increase the capital, the company's money. So that's the reason he got angry. So that's the reason Obiora came to gossip my brother to me.
Since I've known for the way that we are, this person would have caused problem between both of us.
But it's not possible now. That's the reason I called you first to ask you.
Huh. People are
it's
so mean.
It's all right, Frank. It's all right.
This is crazy.
It's all right. Just come in. Let me give you something to eat. I prepared a very good food.
No, don't worry about that, sister. Maybe I'll come back in the evening to eat. Right now, I have a lot of errands to tackle. All right?
Wow.
Yeah, I need to work. Mm. So I'll see you maybe in the evening, okay?
Be very careful.
Yes, I will.
Especially with the car. It's not yours.
But it
really suits you.
I will, but it's not my turn to drive this kind of car.
I know. You're trying to build the capital.
Yeah. All right, I'll see you later.
All right.
Frank, you sent for me. What is that? Frank! What is the meaning of this?
Alright, it means you now have enough time to do your gossip.
Oh, Mr. Frank, you know that I did not do anything to deserve this. I put all my best in this company to make sure that this company is booming.
We have gathered here today to pay a libation and respect to our king. Our revered king of our kingdom who was brutally murdered by unknown gunmen. We have come to seek revenge.
Yes, sir.
We have come to demand that you retaliate.
Yes, that's what.
Bring them to book.
That's what.
And let them be disgraced. Fish them out and punish them accordingly. We are in a CEO. Kind of big better, kind of Cusio. Get a life of Tafafu from Bosik. Tafafu from Bosio. Tafafu from Bosiafu. Oh, what about wager? Huh? No matter where they run to, fish them out. Taham Bosom.
You say,
Dagogani. I now see anywhere they run to, they are in trouble. Okay, do it. Bossy, okay. Do it. Bossy, okay. Can't you, Bossy, have?
He said,
Bossy, okay, on the highest level. No peace, no rest. Until they come out, they must be brought to book and punished accordingly. Ghosts of our ancestors. Everything we say today, we will have your backing. And so be it.
May their paths be filled with thorns.
He said,
may the die.
Ise.
May their night falls in daytime.
Ise. And may they suffer the recompense of their wickedness.
Ise.
And by this auction, let them become a taboo to human race. Anywhere they are, one by one. Mbosi Eke, Mbosi Orie, Mbosi Afo, Mbosi Nkwa, I don't know, but you know, I'm going to go to the house.
I've been talking to you, asking you questions, yet you're not answering. Why are you frowning? What's the matter, princess? My darling, what is it?
Mom, it's your brother. It's Frank. Frank refused to give me the money. Of course, that is after insulting me and telling me his usual stories of contracts here and there.
He insulted you?
He did.
Well, I'm sorry, but I want you to understand that Frank doesn't have money for now. Of course, he invested, you know, in one contract and, well, all I'm trying to say, there is no money for now, but very soon we'll be fine.
Mom, what has come over you? What is going on? Why do you believe him so much so that you just believe there's a contract somewhere and money's waiting to be collected? Is it because he's your brother? He tells you all these lies and then you just take everything. Mommy, can't you see? Can't you see that there's no contract anywhere? I mean, this very contract he's using as an excuse was the same contract father was doing while he was alive and the family was fine. There was no excuse like this. Mommy, there is no contract anywhere. He's lying.
How can you say your brother is lying? Your uncle can be lying. Of course there is contract somewhere. The only thing is for us to be a little bit patient with him, that's all. Just relax a bit. Please, that's all I'm saying. Frank is really trying, you know, but just that you're not seeing it. Now listen, when the federal government pays in this 11.9 billion, you know that money is huge, it's large, it's not here. When the money comes, we'll be fine. So just relax, please.
Mommy, you surprise me.
How?
Okay, how am I supposed to go back to school? What am I going to do? Where's the money going to come from? Because I do not even have any money in my savings.
Listen, I promise you, you'll go back to school. I mean, even if it means me going to ask for loan from somebody, I don't mind. Yes, but you will go back to school.
Mom, do you know who you are? Do you know who you are, Mommy? You want to go out there seeking for a loan? Mommy, why are you refusing to understand the fact that this brother of yours is nothing but a scam? He's a scammer, Mommy! There is no money anywhere!
No, now. You can say anything you want to say. But I will not condone you calling my brother names. Your uncle is not a scammer. Please! Come on now, we know too well how I was begging Frank to come and occupy this position, yet he refused. You know how long it took me to convince him. He reluctantly agreed, and now you are here in front of me calling him a scammer. Ah, I thought you better, sweetheart. Please delete such a thing from your mind. He's not and will never be. Please.
Mom, I sincerely hope that by the time you realize this, it's not too late.
My love,
I call you out here to appreciate you for everything. Especially for your patience with me all through my times of struggle. Huh?
Yeah, baby.
I know I've been through a lot. And you were there with me. All through the hard times. Huh? And so I brought you out here to let you know that I'm happy. I'm happy you stood by me. I would love you to check your phone to see.
Check my phone?
Yeah, check your phone. I sent a token to you.
Jesus Christ. Wait, baby. You're kidding, right?
No, I'm not.
This is one million naira.
Yes. Sent you 1 million naira. You deserve it. And even more. And trust me, from where this is coming, there are more.
Thank you so much.
I love you too. So, this is cheers to a new beginning. To us.
To us forever. I love you.
Love you too.
Oh my God. Jeez.
Princess?
Mom?
Have this. That's 300,000 naira.
Please manage it. Go back to school. By the time you return, I must have arranged for more money for you. But please, for now, use this one wisely. You know how things are.
And where did you get this? Did your brother eventually give you money, or you borrowed it?
Of course I borrowed it.
What? Mom, so you mean you went ahead to borrow money, despite all I told you? No. There's no way I'm keeping this. No. Take it back.
I don't understand.
I can't have it.
Why not? How are you going to cope? You don't even have feeding money. You don't have transport fare. So how will you cope in school?
I'll manage the little that I have. I think I'll go by road, at least. That's, takes care of that transport part.
Why? I mean, how can I sit and watch my little daughter suffer like this, traveling by road? God. I wonder why this federal government doesn't want to release this money for us. Let them at least try and release this money. Knowing how much Frank invested in this contract, it's not a small money. And it's successful. It's just left for the federal government to reciprocate by, giving us back this huge amount of money for this family at least to be happy again. But I'm not even asking them to pay that amount. All I'm saying, let them give us little, at least for us to solve problems in this family. I don't mind. Well, I think I know what to do. Princess, I think I have to sell one of your father's cats. Of course, for us to survive.
That's a joke, right?
How do you mean?
Mom, you can't possibly be thinking of selling daddy's cars. It's barely 6 months daddy died and you're here contemplating on selling his property? Please, mommy, that is way too early. All right? This shouldn't even come up at all. It's not possible. You can't do that.
I understand,
but it's just for us to survive. Your dad is dead already.
Mom, it's not proper, okay? You can't. I think, given the circumstance, the best thing to do is for me to sell off my own car. I mean, that sounds a bit fair.
I mean, what's the point driving a car in school when I have all of these issues? I think I should sell my car. I will sell my car. Sell my car. That's the best. That's the best thing to do. What is going on? What are you doing walking along the road? I sighted you from afar. Aren't you supposed to be at work? It's work hour.
You mean office work?
Yes.
I'm no longer working in your father's company.
You resigned?
No. Your uncle, Frank, sacked me.
What?
Because I came to your house and told your mother everything that has been happening in that company. How Frank is running that company down. Diverting every company's contract to himself. Building his own personal houses with company's money. Worker's salary for complete fools. But your mother did not listen to me. He just shouted at me and chased me out of the house. She later told Frank what I said. And Frank sacked me. So since then, I've been working under the sun, under the rain. Looking for a job.
Oh my god. 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 So you mean you told my mother all of this and it's ended with sack instead?
My princess, the story did not end there. The first day Frank resumed work in the company as the managing director, he sacked Mr. Johnson. Mr. Johnson told your father every fraud he is committing in that company. As I speak with you now, Mr. Johnson is also searching for a job.
For real? Wait a minute. All of this is going on in my father's company and nobody told me about it. So Frank becoming the managing director of my father's company is just to make a mess of my father's legacy over the years and turn the company upside down?
Yes, my princess.
Oh my God. Where can I find Mr. Johnson?
Mr. Johnson?
Yes, where can I find him? Do you know where I can find him?
Yes, yes.
You do?
Yes.
Is it possible that you take me there?
Why not?
Please, 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 if you don't mind, let's go.
It's okay, it's okay, it's okay.
My princess, I would so appreciate it if you and your mother can do everything you can to stop Frank's excesses in running that company. Because if nothing is done in the next 3 months, Frank is going to liquidate that company.
He's evil. He has no interest of you, your mother, nor the companies at heart.
Please, if I take you to my mom, will you be able to repeat this before her? I mean, so that at least she can hear this from you directly.
Oh, why not?
My princess, I'm ready to tell your mother everything I have not even told you yet. And if she doubts it, let her verify from the other stuff.
In that case, what are we waiting for? Please, can you just come with me already?
Let's go.
Please, thank you so much. Please get in.
Mom, I just want to beg you to calm down and listen to what they have to tell you. Please.
Listen to which people, if I may ask? I'm asking you, which people? You mean these two? These animals that you brought from the zoo to do what? I'm asking you, what have you come
have to do is enough to gossip. That's all they are good at.
Mom.
If you mom me one more word, I'm asking you. You came, right? To gossip Frank. Frank all the time. A young boy you can give back to. You should be ashamed of yourself. Just take a look at you. Why? Because it's... Hey! I'm not done. You, Obiora, the other time you came to my house, what did you come to do? If I may ask, gossip. Instead of you to tell me that you want or you wanted my brother to give you a loan for you to go get married, then build a house. The young man that is hardworking refused because he's trying to build my late husband's company. That's the reason you hated him so much.
Ooh.
And you, I'm talking to you, you animals, you. You in particular, now you listen to me. Look at me when I'm talking to you. You in particular, were you not the one who framed my brother up in front of my husband and my husband sat him? Why? Because you were eyeing his position. The position did you get? No, you didn't. So why can't you let Frank be? No, you cannot. Now you listen to me. At a count of three, if you two idiots don't leave this place, you will regret it when I return.
Mom.
And you!
Yes, Mom.
Princess.
Mom.
I am ashamed of you. Bringing these two animals. Does this place look like zoo to you? Now you better return them where you brought them from. Else, you will not like what I will do to you, you and you. I'm still counting.
I'm really sorry. Sorry for this embarrassment. All right, this was unintended. I'm sorry. It's my fault. So I just want to beg you to go for now. I mean, just give me some time to talk to my mom.
You know, this whole revelation right now from your mother, it's so shocking to me. Not just me alone here, including Obiora. But it's all right, my princess. Sincerely, the fault is not yours. But I know time shall come when your mother will come to understand us and what has been playing out here.
Can you imagine?
But I only just pray that it will never be too late when that time will come.
Can you imagine? Hey, Josie, can you imagine? Frank lied against me that I asked him for loan to build a house and get married. Second wife or third wife? Try. Anyway, I will not be.
It's all right, my princess.
Yes. I'm so sorry, okay? I'm sorry. Really sorry. Please just blame it on me, okay? I take full responsibility for all this.
I'm fine, and I'm not fine. I have body pains, I have a headache, and that's because I came by road, so I'm really stressed.
Oh, so sorry.
It's okay.
Sorry.
No, it's fine, just that my body hurts.
By road?
Mm-hmm.
Why? You missed your flight or there was no flight?
Mm-hmm. My sister. I didn't miss my flight though. There was actually no money to buy a ticket. My uncle refused to give me money. I'm talking about my dad's money, not his.
Of course.
So he didn't give me money for tickets, not even money for school. So I had to manage the little that I have. So I came by road.
Did you talk to your mom about it? What did she say?
She confronted him, you know,
But of course, he came up with the usual story of, you know, his money's been stuck with the federal government for the contracts he executed. And my mom believed him anyways, but I don't. Right now, I'm just praying to God to help me scale through with my education, because I cannot wait to take over my father's company, because that's about the first thing I'm going to do as soon as I'm done with my studies. So somehow I just have to find a way through all of this. Yeah.
This is really bad. Sorry.
No, it's fine. So what's up with you? What about you? Why? I'm sorry, my mood kind of dampened your excitement. What's the excitement about? What's the good news?
Praise things. I'm so happy. I don't know what to say. I don't know how to say it. Okay. Are you ready for the gist?
Of course. Updates me. What's good?
FK, my boyfriend. I went to see him.
You mean the same FK you've been telling me about, or a brand new one?
The same FK I have been telling you about. My boyfriend is now a billionaire. Babe, FK gave me 1 million naira. Also gave me money to book my flight ticket.
Wait. The same FK who doesn't give you transport fare?
I'm telling you.
Gave you 1 million naira.
1 million naira.
And booked you a flight. My goodness.
Can you imagine this?
Oh, wow.
I hope I'm not dreaming.
No, of course you're not. Listen, you deserve this and more, darling.
Thank you.
I mean, your patience is paying off.
Thank you,
I'm happy for you.
Thank you for all you do for me.
Come on. Wow. Should I say congratulations? Or I don't know. Congratulations. Sorry about my mood, of course. I was already in this mood before you came in.
I understand.
It has nothing to do with what you're saying. But trust me, I'm happy for you, my darling. I am.
I know you are.
Wow.
So, let me now surprise you, my best friend.
With what?
And then you will see.
Wow.
Check your phone. I just sent you 400,000 naira. Please.
Stop it.
You just have to manage it. Okay? At least you can get yourself some things.
You sent me four.
It's nothing now.
400,000.
Mm-hmm.
Of course it's something. Do you know what this money can do for me in my present state?
Oh, please.
This is a lot.
It's not a lot compared to what you have been doing for me.
Goodness.
You're happy?
I don't know what to say. I mean, I'm in total shock.
You don't have to say anything.
Esther.
You have been doing more than this for me. Come on. Forget about your uncle, okay? Whenever you need anything,
come. You want to make me cry.
Anytime you need anything, now that my boyfriend is rich, just call me.
If you don't know what it means, it's a good person that gives, not a rich person. You give because you have good hearts.
You are good.
I don't want to cry.
Don't think about your uncle anymore.
Thank you.
Don't cry, baby. You know I love you.
Thank you.
Don't cry.
Are you crying? I'm trying not to cry.
Easy. Down. Go. Down.
Are you taking me to?
It's alright, just come. Easy. Alright, one step down. Another step down.
Yeah. Babe.
Yep.
What's going on?
Alright, I want you to guess what's going on.
You know I can't guess.
Come on, you can guess. Try something.
I can't. Stop keeping me in suspense.
Okay. I will not keep you in suspense anymore.
What's going on?
I'll just untie your blindfold so you get to see what I have for you. There you go.
course, go ahead. It's your car.
Oh my God! Mr. Pearls, I have a surprise for you. I was thinking something nice, you know. If I know it,
go away! What?
Going.
I'm so happy for you. My God.
Yes. Money, baby. Go ahead.
You know what? See, you are going to take me round town. I think we should have a dinner.
Dinner,
maybe,
right?
Yes, maybe something. Can I just change so you take me out in your new car, please?
I'm waiting.
By the way. My God.
I can't believe you're driving like this good. When did you even learn how to drive? Because you and I know that before now you couldn't even, you know, start a car.
Jesus Christ.
What was Jesus Christ about
say
that?
Say insult. Wait, my princess. You didn't try insult me.
Are you pretending? I know you cannot even pretend with me because I know you better than yourself. Alright?
How are you so sure?
Can you start telling me who taught you how to drive?
Well, thank God, where I was that from?
No, but it's okay. The most important thing is you're so perfect. Your grip is very strong.
Mm-hmm.
At least I'm safe in your car. We're not going to climb a pole.
Before you leave here. Oh, I'm scared, okay? I got you covered.
I know. I can see the confidence.
I'm so happy.
Don't worry, I'm happier for you, my love.
FK, Gary surprised me.
I can't even believe it. Like, he just bought this car and dashed you.
I swear. He blindfolded me. He said, come, I have something for you. I was like, what?
One good thought is a proposal. I think that's the first thing that will come to my mind. Didn't you at some point think he was, you know, trying to propose?
No, like...
What were you thinking in your mind when you were blindfolded?
In my mind, I was like, where is this guy taking a bit?
My God.
Oh.
So, but this FK of yours, I don't know. Are you sure this is for real? Are you sure of him?
Of course. I'm very sure. Very, very sure. 100%. He's caring. I mean, it's every woman's dream. I'm lucky.
Can't wait to meet him, though.
Sure you will. Will you travel with me? Please, since you're going home, let's go together. FK will see you.
So, but are you sure you can drive us safe home?
I understand.
Fly my
you'll
fly.
You'll be princess. I'm just respecting you because you'll be princess. Please, don't insult me.
No, I'm just saying, Abby. Just in case, so are you sure this driving you're driving is not just speeding
down? Come and drive. Come and drive.
No, but it's actually gonna be fun for us to do like a road trip.
Yeah.
Like girls' road trip.
Yeah, it's gonna be
with fun. Loud music.
How did you know?
It's been a long time I did that, so I don't mind. And at least that would also avail me the opportunity to meet him.
Same here. Woo! I'm so happy.
Me too.
Thank you so much for everything.
For what?
Thank you for always being there for me, caring for me, a girl without father and mother.
It's okay, now you want to make me cry.
You're not my mother, you're not my father, you're not my sister, my brother, my everything. Yeah,
and I'm happy there's FK now in your life who's taking care of you.
No. FK is there, but you mean a lot to me. Oh, no, I can't trend you for anything.
That's so sweet.
I love you.
Love you too.
Love you. Thank you. Welcome to my boyfriend's house.
What?
wow.
Sorry. Sorry for keeping you waiting.
So happy for you.
Thank you.
I mean, whose cars are these?
My boyfriend's cars.
Your boyfriend owned these cars?
Of course. These two plus the one you drove out with.
Sorry, is he renting or he bought? I mean the house. Is he renting?
Renting, okay. He owns the house. Are you shocked?
I am.
I told you he's
well,
you a
know
big
what?
Guy.
I'm so happy, like, so happy for you.
I know.
Goodness.
Thank you. Please go.
Thank you.
Hi, my princess. Hmm.
Goodness, I can't believe that this is your place.
Yeah, this is my home to be.
Girl, you're living in heaven.
Thank you. Make yourself comfortable, okay? I'll be right back. Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine. Is this FK?
Yeah, that's my guy.
Huh?
Sweetheart, I've been telling you about. He's cute, right? Are you okay?
Not at all. I mean, he's so cute.
Yeah, come on, sit.
Goodness. Oh, so this is the guy you've been talking about?
Mm-hmm. He's the one.
Unbelievable.
Thank you.
I have known FK I've been hearing of his name all my life. I never thought he was gonna be this cute.
He's cute, right?
Are you asking me? My goodness.
That's my guy. I love you so much.
I'm so happy for you.
Thank you.
I feel like you're living in heaven.
Of course. How did you know that? You sure you're okay? You're all right.
I am. I'm just a little worried about you. There's this unrest I feel inside.
Worried about me?
Yes, I mean, this your FK guy, considering how young, rich, and handsome he is. You know, I mean, he's been taking care of you, doing practically everything for you, including buying you a car.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think there's a future here?
I don't understand.
I mean, I don't want you to come crying. He looks like someone who's going to be a specialist in breaking hearts.
Not my FK.
Are you sure?
This guy,
uh-huh.
He's everything to me. I love him so much. Like, I trust him.
I mean,
believe me.
It's okay for you to love him, but how are you sure he loves you, like, right back?
I know.
How?
See, he promised to build a house for me in the village. Hmm? He has done enough. He's cute, he's sincere. I mean, he's so real.
Have you tried to put him through some kind of tests? To be sure that you're not going to come crying.
Test?
Mm-hmm.
No.
What do you mean, no? I mean, if you're so sure that he loves you, I mean, you can just try him. Nothing spoils if he passes the test.
What kind of test?
Listen, I'm just speaking as your friend, all right? Because I'm really, really worried. I wasn't this worried when I didn't, like, see him because I've never seen a picture of him before. You know, but seeing how he looks, my dear, I can tell you that this guy doesn't really love you as much as you love him. I can tell you for free.
Oh, my princess, please don't go there. Not my FK.
Okay, fine. If he loves you, then test him. How about you teasing him or tactically asking,
asking for his, maybe asking him to show you his properties, maybe investments here and there, because a guy will only do that if he's sure that you are going to be his wife. He won't do that with just a random girl. So if he doesn't, then you know that that man is not for you.
Okay, let me bust your bubbles. Is it the guy?
Mm-hmm.
FK, my boyfriend, my love, my sweetheart.
Mm-hmm.
I know everything about him. Both his documents, everything. He doesn't hide anything from me. So there is no need of testing him.
Liar.
I'm serious.
You know, I can tell you're lying.
Me lying to you?
Like, you know things about his properties, you know things about the documents of his properties.
Everything! Okay.
Oh, please.
I will prove you wrong.
Lies.
Come with me to his room.
So a guy as cute and rich and young as this will show you his investment in properties. You're not even his wife yet.
That is to show you how much we trust each other. Come with me.
Are you for real?
Let's go to his room. I'll show you everything.
You're serious, right?
I'm serious. Your phone.
Wow.
Let's go. Dizzy.
Mm-hmm.
Contains all the documents of my boyfriend's properties, both developed and undeveloped ones.
For real?
Spotlight.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Do you know that I didn't even believe it when you were... My goodness.
Look at this. I told you.
These are a lot.
Yeah.
You mean... Wow. Look, I am so happy for you. I don't even know what to say.
You're happy
I mean,
now.
Of course, I am.
I know.
Look, at least now I can be rest assured that my girlfriend is in a safe hand. Yeah.
You can say that again.
Put them back. Wow.
I'm so happy that you're happy.
Of course, this is so, so nice. Wait, let me help you. Let me help you, Zipa.
Okay.
Whoa.
So,
ain't you so lucky?
I'll be right back.
God, this is unbelievable.
You're convinced now?
Undoubtedly.
Are you okay?
Mm-hmm. I have a light headache.
Sorry.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get you water?
Okay. Right. Water is fine.
I'm coming.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Do you by any chance have a painkiller here? To suppress it?
Yeah, I think I have Panadol. Should I get you Panadol?
No, I don't. I'm allergic to Panadols. I only take paracetamol. Is there a pharmacy next door?
Yeah, very close.
Please, maybe you can just get me paracetamol, please.
All right.
Oh my goodness.
Sure you're good. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Thank you.
Where's my butter?
Oh, it's right here, but don't worry. I was actually waiting for you to come back. This took a while. I have to go.
Go?
I feel a bit sick.
Can I drop you off?
No, you don't have to. Let me just go home and take care of myself. I just thought of something. Meeting your boyfriend for the first time and him meeting me sick.
Why not rest a little bit?
No, I don't want to rest. You know, I don't want your boyfriend to meet me sick. You know, I've been meeting him for the first time. First impression matters. That's not a good way to meet someone. Of course it matters. First impression matters, okay? I'll be fine.
Let me take you home.
No, you don't have to. Stay back and cook for your man. You know, you're almost a married woman now.
Are you sure?
And that's what makes a good woman. Cook for your husband to be. I'll just drive myself home.
Are you sure?
I'll take this when I get home. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Let me know.
No, don't worry. Oh my God.
I care. Sorry.
Thank you.
Are you serious? Chai, you have been sick for the past 2 weeks and nobody told me. But Papa, why now? Are you serious? I'm sorry. Is Frank aware that you're not feeling too well? He's away and he couldn't even take you to the hospital. I beg your pardon. Buy medicine from pharmacy. Well, since you said you're getting better, it's all right. It's all right. In that case, I'll come and see you next week. All right. Chai.
Mom, who was that?
My father.
Is he sick?
Yes. He told me he's been down for the past 2 weeks. I'm not even aware.
Oh my God.
Though he said he's getting better. And from his voice, I think he's getting better.
Whew, thank God.
Hold on. Are you done resting?
Mm-hmm. I'm okay now, Mom.
Okay.
I'm fine. Mom, I'd like to ask you. I'd love to ask you a question, if you don't mind.
What is it about?
When was the last time you heard from your brother, Frank?
Yesterday. Okay. We spoke yesterday. Any problem?
Any problem? Like, seriously, you asking me that? Mom, it's obvious there's a problem. What's the latest updates about the billions the government owes him? What's new?
What's new is that he told me that they will be paying in middle of next month. That's what's new.
And you believed him?
Why will I not believe him?
How else do I make you realize that this brother of yours is nothing but a scam, a fraudster, a very...
Come on, will you close your mouth? What is coming for you? God have mercy. Do you realize the person you're calling names is my younger brother and your uncle? Are you insane? I mean, I remembered when I gave birth to you. Frank was here. The way Frank carried you and everything. What is all this? I mean, I can't watch you sit in front of me and you're calling my brother names. No, stop! Please pull my leg, Joa. Your own is becoming too much.
Listen, Divya. We came to ask you why Ogogo has not taken any action since the death of our Igwe. We came to lead complaint concerning our Igwe's death. And you told us that Frank is responsible for the death of our Igwe.
Yeah.
But to our surprise, up till now, Frank is walking freely everywhere in the village. Eh? Everywhere in the village. Please, don't let us begin to think that Ogogo is powerless. Eh? Let Ogogo take action immediately. Let there be result. So that they will not think we elders are liars too.
Of course.
The ways of the gods is different from the ways of we human. Ogogo Adarahola.
You people should go home and allow Ogogo to go for a revenge. Now, both of you should leave my shrine. I have something to do.
Thank you, Ezebide. Thank you very much.
Here, sir. These are all the documents, I mean original documents, of all the properties he bought with my father's company funds.
This is good. This is good. With all these documents here, he'll be disgraced in court if we present our case well. But we need to convincingly establish a case of misappropriation and mismanagement of funds against him.
Okay. In that case, let's head to court.
First, we need to start disgracing him by getting him arrested, then take him to court where we will seize all the stolen funds from him, then kick him out.
What are we waiting for? Let's start immediately.
In that case, I have to call the commissioner of police to get him arrested.
Okay, okay.
Then I'll get back to you.
That's perfect. Alright, so I'll just leave you to do all you have to do while I wait to get the feedback.
Okay.
Thank you very much. I'll be on my way now.
No, don't mention, don't mention.
Alright, have a nice day, barrister.
You're welcome.
Frank. This one, you're sounding like this. I hope all is well. I can't hear you well. What? That what happened? How? My own daughter arrested you? What did you do to her? My goodness. Frank, which police station? And you're sure you didn't do anything to my daughter? She just arrested you. Are you serious? All right, Frank. I'm coming.
Good afternoon, Mom.
My brother just called me now, telling me that you arrested him. Why?
I don't have anything to explain to you as regards that.
I beg your pardon. What is that supposed to mean?
You're not going to believe me, Mom. I mean, I don't have so much to explain to you about this useless and selfish brother of yours.
What? Right before me, you call my brother names? You're not even afraid that Frank is your mom's younger brother. You had a nerve to arrest my own brother and you call him names before me. What did he do to you?
Mom, like I said, I am not going to explain too much. Okay? What is most important is the bottom line has been drawn. I am not backing down. I am going to deal with this brother of yours so much so that when he sees me coming from one end of the road, he's going to run into the bush.
Keeping quiet, princess. I'm just respecting you because you're my daughter. I would have dealt with you my own way. Princess, you're pushing me.
Trying to open my door.
Oh, I forgot, Princess Ada could change the key.
And what do you mean, Princess Ada could change the keys? Sir, did I tell her my keys are having issues?
Sir, I think you should see her and sort out things with her.
And where is she?
She's at the board meeting. That's where I'm coming from.
Ada could call the board meeting without my permission? What's the meaning of this? Why would he call for a board meeting without my permission? And why in God's name did you lock up my office?
Did I just hear you say permission? I do not need permission from you to hold a board meeting. In case you've forgotten, this is my father's company. All right? So, do I need permission from you? Of course not.
So who are these people?
That, please pardon my bad manners. These are the external auditors I brought in to audit the company's account so far, especially from the part where you became managing director. Since the accounts are not tallying. And gentlemen and lady, this is the acting managing director holding for me.
You're welcome, sir.
If you don't mind, we're stepping out, so.
How the management meeting without your consent after taking you to the police station? My goodness! Is she insane?
Mommy, she's definitely not insane. I am not insane. I mean, what have I done wrong? What have I done wrong? Oh, you think you can just come here and report to my mother? Is that going to save your sorry ass? I mean, what have I done wrong, Mommy? Nothing! I just asked you to give accounts. Grant me access to my father's account and you're reporting me to my mother? Mom, who is this man to stop me from vetting my father's account? That's my father's company. I told you, didn't I? I warned you. I told you a day like this will come where you have to give account of everything you have done in that company, and that day is now. Coming here to report me.
Now will you shut up and listen?
Are you insane? Can you imagine the way you're raising your voice at my brother?
Your uncle!
Just imagine.
He was even there when I gave birth to you. Are you mad?
I'm not mad. I will not shut up. Yes, fine, if you want me to listen to you, I will listen to you because you're my mom. But, Mommy, can't you see? How else do I make you understand that this brother of yours is nothing but evil? He's evil! And I need you to see him for what he truly is.
Sister, did you hear that? Did you hear Adaku call me evil? Adaku of yesterday.
Okay.
Adaku, I clean her poo.
I'm telling you.
Call me evil right before you. Sister, I know how you begged me to take up this job.
I know
how you begged me to come help you run this company. I refused, but you insisted. And now this. Adaku has the guts to call me evil.
It's okay.
You know what, sister? Right here, right now.
No,
I am
not
done.
So fast. No way. Come on, quit. You can't just quit just like that. I mean, why are you running? Why? Of course you're going to quit, but not before you submit every account that has to do with my father's company. You think you're smart? You want to run away? I can see through you. You're going nowhere.
Sister, I'm not going to stay here to exchange words with this little girl.
No,
I will not do that.
No, no, come back. Come back. Why are you running?
Hey, come on, will you keep quiet?
Enough. Now go to your room. One. I say move to your room. Come on, will you?
Fine. Leave it. Fine.
Goodness God. Now what is all this?
This is a joke, right? Huh? What is this?
Mama, we tried our best. We...
What nonsense is this? I mean, this is what I paid for. Is this? I don't get it. Oh! So you have been bought by that idiot. Huh? You have been bought to make a mess of your result, of your parents' money, sending you to school, to become something reasonable in life, and then you make a joke of your own profession by handing me over this nonsense. Even the blind can see. I can see through your irregularities. Your figures are not adding up. Are you serious? Oh, you know what? Get the hell out of my office. Get the hell out. You're so cheap! My God! For how much? I could even audit better than an auditor. What? My elders, that is the current situation. I am beyond grateful to my friend who made me realize all this.
Thank God for her.
Good one, my princess. What about the documents?
I handed over all documents to the lawyer. He has them.
Very thoughtful of you. Wonderful. And does your mother know about all these properties and cars?
No, not a word. I didn't tell her anything. I haven't, so far.
My fellow elders, that little useless, fool and useless boy killed our Igwe. It shall be confirmed by Oracle Ogugu and Esemo. And since we have asked him to come and take an oath to prove his innocence, he refused. Since he refused, we have to go and see Ezemo. Tell him to visit him anywhere he is.
Ichi, I think there's no need for that. You see, the last time we went to see Ezemo.
Yes.
He told us not to bother ourselves. That Ogugu will do his own thing at the right time.
But that will not stop us from going to Ogugu to tell Ezemo about the court case. To him to do something so that he will come out in shame.
In shame. Yeah. Shame.
Capital shame.
He will definitely come out in shame.
Who is he? Obonye. Obonye. Etiele ebandu mo yagbamu.
Well, you have all spoken well about this matter. And at this juncture, Ichi Chikwadu has spoken it all. He said it all. we the other shall proceed straight to Ezemo. So that we brief him on the current situation of things and also hear some few instructions from him.
Okay.
Oh, no. We now know which way to follow.
Yeah, that's
meanwhile, our princess, the pride of our kingdom.
Exactly.
We are so happy.
Hmm?
Princess.
Ah, princess.
Are you once a CID?
Oh, don't know her.
Ask Nabrede and Ridike, and Nabrede Kaja Madike. I want to send a Kurung and Ngo. Naya Kalakana healing Guru. O Krikrikana Bukos in Ahalienu. Nkonya Meta Obulu. Ask Nobelabum when we are Bola Jogo. Alupua na fonde mo. Nkonya Meta Missie.
Or
from Gabana Kia. Or from Gabano. Ofan gabana fo
ise
ofan gabana nko
ise
na fela no nizu na no
ise
ko he meta ya weli si ebulu
ise
For the past days, you have not been yourself. What's going on? Are you okay?
Shit. That's nothing. You see, I have a lot of work at the office to do, and it's overwhelming, you know. I sometimes forget about myself. It's just work, nothing more to it. I'll be fine.
Honey, are you sure?
Yeah, I'm fine. Trust me, I am.
Just that I'm worried.
You don't need to. What the hell is that?
What?
What the hell is that? Huh?
What's what? That?
Huh?
What's it?
Ah! Oh my God! Ah! Oh my God! Oh my God! What is it? What is it? What do you want from me? What do you want from me?
Go to Ogugu Shrine and confess to the people of Izanagbo Kingdom how you killed the king. Else, you will be disgraced before the entire kingdom.
I will go nowhere. You can do nothing! I am innocent!
Frank, I need you to look at me. Stop pressing this your phone. I don't like what you're doing, Frank. Are you looking at me in such manner? Frank, listen. You know it's only you and I. Why will I be begging you for things? I have been calling you. Frank, I've been begging you for money, for you to assist my family. You know how things are for my children and I. Yet, you kept pushing me around like I don't even matter to you.
Sister,
I'm your ish.
I'm as worried as
I am not finished. I'm no pujurugono, but chill. Now, what has come over you? It's only you and I, you. Eh, Frank? My husband died. Things are so tough for us. Please help me. Let me sort things out in this family. Please. Let me at least assist your cousins. You told me that the government is owing you billions of naira.
Of course.
The question is, have they paid you? If yes, even if it's little, give your sister, please. And if no, when will they pay? Is it when we are dead?
I am as worried as you are right now. The government has refused to pay me our money. They don't want to release this money to me. As we speak, it's just 3,000 naira, 3K I have in my pocket to survive on. I'm even thinking of suing them or sending them to court.
No, 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 no.
So they can pay me my money.
No, 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 no.
I'm tired of the whole thing.
No, no, no. Pick one name. I don't want to lose you. How can you sue government? Please. Even if you sue them now. Where's the money you will use to defend yourself in the court? Do you think it's easy? Is it the 3,000 in your pocket that you will use? It's okay. Don't worry. Please. It's okay. Well, another thing. What's going on between you and my daughter? Why are you two fighting? What's the matter? Eh? Why? I mean, is there anything that both of you are not telling me?
Sister, it's the same matter. It's all about this money. This money that the government is owing me. The same issue. She has refused to understand. Because I am the one directly connected to the whole deal. That's why she's mad at me. For the wrong reason.
Oh, I get it now. So that's the reason both of you are fighting all the time.
Yes.
I don't understand. I mean, Princess should understand that my brother is not the government.
I don't know. Please let me talk to her. Let me explain things to her so that she can understand.
I will talk to her. Don't worry.
Okay.
Once she comes back, I will talk to her. But if she refuses to listen, and still wants to carry the matter to court, relax, I will defend you.
Sister, please defend me. Defend me. I don't want to die on time. This whole thing is driving me crazy.
Now, who is talking about death? God forbid you will never die. Nothing will happen to you in Jesus' name.
Amen. But the stress is too much on me now.
Just try now. Try. Just try and ask the government. Try. Let them release the money.
I'm sending messages.
Madam, sorry, I was checking something very important in someone else's case.
That's right.
Yeah. I can't remember meeting you before. So what brought you to my office?
My name is Lolo Namaka of Izinabo Kingdom. My late husband calls me Obiagili Akuya. My late husband was His Royal Majesty Cletus of Izinabo Kingdom, who just passed away. Your Lordship, I was supposed to be here with my younger brother called Mr. Frank Ubiako. But funny enough, he couldn't make it, so I decided to come see you, you know, just to seek your help.
You're welcome, Your Majesty. I was supposed to be in your late husband's last Ofala, but unfortunately, as a Dane, I was in London. Please accept my condolence.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you.
And what can I do for you at this time?
Okay, Your Lordship. Like I said earlier, I was supposed to be here with my brother Frank, but he couldn't make it, so I decided to come see you alone. Well, it's about my husband's business. When my husband passed away, I pleaded with my brother to come help me take over my husband's company, which he accepted. And my husband's business is known for executing contracts. So it then happened that my brother came in and took a large amount of money from my husband's company to execute a contract with the federal government. And this money we're talking about, yes, is in billions of naira. Billions of naira. And up until now, we are not yet paid. We are still expecting the government to pay us, but it's as if it's not forthcoming. So, my daughter became angry and started suspecting a foul play, which I am not suspecting anything because I trust my brother. He would not do anything that will hurt me. So my daughter started threatening my younger brother that she's going to sue him if he doesn't return the company's money. So I'm begging my daughter, please, be patient. But she refused. Finally, she carried out her threat by, suing my brother. So the reason for me coming is that I'm certain that this case will be, called out in your own court. Which is why I'm here for you to at least help us. Please.
Oh, so Mr. Frank Obiako is your younger brother?
Yes, please.
Wow, impressive. He was actually here a few minutes ago, just before you came in.
Frank was here?
Yeah. He was here. And I actually told them what to do. To squash the case,
Okay, you told him what to do to squash the case.
Yeah.
If I may ask, Your Lordship, what was the thing you told him?
Very simple. It's nothing too big, too serious. It's, I only asked him to give me a sum of 50 million to be able to...
50 million? What?
Yeah. Comparing to what you're talking about here, the gravity of this matter is not something that should be too much to offer. So, 50 million.
50 million? And please, Your Lordship, what was my brother's response when you mentioned 50 million naira?
Of course, you're obliged. You're obliged.
Frank obliged?
Yeah.
All right. All right, Your Lordship, I'll be on my way now.
That'll be fine, Your Majesty.
Thank you for your time.
Looking forward to hearing from your son.
You will.
Hello? Princess, there's a situation at hand. Please, where are you? I'll make you to come to my office. No, this is not time for questions. I would rather see you in the office. Please. Okay. I'll be waiting.
Hello, Frank. Frank, I don't understand what's going on. How can you promise the judge you're going to give him 50 million naira? I mean, I don't get it. How? When government is yet to pay the company the billions of naira they are owing us? No. My question is, how do you intend paying this judge? That's 50 million naira now. Okay, Frank, listen. Let me ask you a question. I mean, is there something that I'm supposed to know which you're not telling me? Because I don't understand. Yes, that's because I... Hello? Hello, Frank.
Mom, why? Mommy, why? Why are you doing this?
Why am I doing what?
What? Like, seriously, you're acting like you don't know, right? No problem. One thing for sure, Mommy, I am going to shock you. I'm going to surprise you.
Now, what are you talking about?
Mom, don't act like you don't know what I'm talking about. You went to the judge's office to tell him to squash my case with your brother. You did that. That is not fair. Why? Listen, whether you like it or not, that wicked brother of yours is going to prison. And there's nothing you can do about it. It is a promise, Mommy.
Hold on. Who told you that?
My lawyer called and told me everything. He did. We're all meeting at the judge's office tomorrow, right? Mom, I can't wait for tomorrow to come. By the time we get to his office tomorrow and the revelation is unveiled before you, you will be the one in a hurry to send that brother of yours to prison. Watch out.
Princess. Princess, hold on. Princess. Princess.
Madam, you were here yesterday pleading on behalf of your brother, you know, concerning the case that your daughter instituted against him. Even though I requested for some certain amount of money to be paid to me, I wasn't really comfortable after you left. I had to call my brother, Barrister Chooks, who happens to be my cousin, of course, and also the same person standing in for your daughter, to bring the case files to me and also the documents. And of course he did. And having gone through it, I found out that your brother, Mr. Frank, has actually been a dubious person. I have documents here, which you may like to also go through. Yes. I would love you to confirm with me the others. It will surprise you to know that your brother Frank has properties worth millions of naira, not just any amount of money, in hundreds of millions scattered all over Nigeria. Please take a look at the document and confirm the name on it, the address, and also the signature. I guess it reflects that of your brother. Not at all, Your Majesty. It will also surprise you to know that the certain money you're talking about has been paid. Mm-hmm. And your brother decided to play smart and fast one on you. But thank God. Thank God that the princess was smart enough and fast to dig him out. And to expose his various activities. Mm-hmm.
I'm dumbfounded. Come on. This is unbelievable. Frank. Mm-hmm. Houses scattered. Hold on, Your Lordship. Are you sure? Somebody's not trying to frame my brother up.
Your Majesty, I just asked. Your Majesty, with all due respect, nobody's framing your brother up. Nobody.
Yes.
Thank you.
How in the world did you get to know all this information without you bringing your mother in?
Mom, I couldn't have brought you into it. Because if I did, you would have told him. And that would have narrowed my chances. Besides, over time, Mommy, I did everything I could to open your eyes to the fact that this brother of yours is nothing but evil. But did you believe me? You didn't.
Frank, it's true you are my brother, but God will punish you for me.
Mom, this is not going to end in court. Because as we speak, the elders are all waiting for him. Frank must have to take an oath as regards my father's sudden death. Because everyone is suspicious of him.
Do I care? Let them do anything they wish to do. My brother is evil. I still can't believe it. Frank. The boy is wicked.
Mommy, can I shock you? I just hope that your heart can handle this.
Will it be more than the one I witnessed in Judge's office? No, now.
Okay.
No, my heart is strong now.
Mom, would you believe it if I say that Frank, your brother, has about 6.9 billion naira of that is money in one of his accounts that I just figured out?
Are you for real?
I am. 6.9 billion.
6.9 billion?
Yes, Mom.
In his account?
Yes.
Different account?
Yes.
It's a lie.
Mom.
It's a lie. How did you get to know this?
Oga.
Musa, what's your problem? Open the bloody gate.
Two people came here this afternoon. They locked the gate. Carry key. Come out. They talked to madam. I don't know what happened, Oga. Hey.
Someone locked my gate?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. But they talked to madam inside.
Where is she?
She there inside.
Is your target? You don't care how it comes. You're too greed and wicked. So much in love with money. Money is what he thinks of. He's ready to kill for it. He's too greed and wicked. He's too greed and wicked. Money is your target. You don't care how it comes. You're too greed and wicked. Money is what he thinks of. He's ready to kill for it. He's too greedy and wicked.
What's he telling me? What's going on?
My six.
Huh? What happened?
Sit down first, please.
I need to know who sealed my gate. What's the meaning of this?
I'm even surprised.
What nonsense is this? I'm not owing anybody. I'm not owing any bank. So why would the court order me to pack out of my house within 7 days without taking anything out of the house? Not even my cars.
I don't know. I can't tell. Honey, please. I think you should go to their office and sort out things with them. Please.
I'm not going anywhere.
Honey, you have to please. Honey? Honey?
listen to me. Baby.
Darling.
Yes, ma'am.
You see, I've been trying so hard not to get you involved in the issues of my life. But right now, I have no other option but to get you fully involved.
Okay, I'm listening.
I've spoken to my insurance company. Spoken to my security personnel. Spoken to my lawyers. And now it's just you who's left. And you're the closest person to me. You see, there are these documents I put in a bag and kept in my wardrobe. Somehow those documents left this house and landed in the hands of my enemies. How it happened, I don't know. So right here, right now, I'm asking you, do you have any idea how those documents left this house? Did your friends at any time come to my house and made away with my documents?
No, I can't remember. None that I know of.
Are you sure about this, Esther?
Yes, babe, I'm sure. Yeah. I came here with a friend of mine, my best friend, from school. So.
And who's this your best friend?
Princess. Princess Adako. She has been my best friend and my roommate. So, I invited her over to come to my man's house, my husband-to-be. So, I showed her some of the documents, so that she will know what my man has achieved in life. And she was so happy. She was very happy at the achievement. I brought her to the room, so I showed her. That's all.
So it's been you. So it's been you all this while. Because of your reckless and stupid behavior, I lost all my documents. I want you to go into this wardrobe now. Pack everything that belongs to you and get the hell out of my house before I commit murder.
Then what are you talking about?
Get the hell out of the house! Now!
Do you know Princess Adako?
You're still there.
Is this... He's not far from a prodigal son. He's wicked, so extravagant. Living life is all he wants.
Manager. Yes, I'm coming to your office right now. I need some cash. What do you mean I can't get any cash? And who gives such orders on my account? Manager, prepare some money for me. What do you mean by that? Hello? Hello? Eh? What happens to my 6.9 billion? You mean it's you? Don't go like that. He's ready to kill for it. He's too great and wicked. I'm going to kill somebody.
Hopi Feregazu, why are you this wicked on your in-law?
my freaking money. Because of you. I worked so hard for it. No more peace in this palace. No
more joy in the palace. You are brought. Mommy, that was what happened. I had to leave. He's not talking to himself. Acting like someone that is getting mad already.
Acting like someone that is getting mad.
He hasn't seen anything yet. This is just the beginning. He's actually going to run mad. I mean, like, mad for real, in real life. He's going to run mad. Rubbish.
Esther.
Mommy?
I want to say a very big thank you to you for making me realize who my brother is. The true Frank, the evil Frank. You and my daughter made me realize that Frank is evil.
Honestly.
I mean, my daughter tried warning me, but, you know, brother's love. I never believed it. But when you came in, you made it easier. I will reward you handsomely for this. I promise.
Mom?
Yes, darling.
Please, can I ask for a favor?
Yeah, go on. What?
Can Esther live here with us for a while? I mean, she's job hunting and she really doesn't have anywhere else to go. Mommy, I didn't tell you. She's actually an orphan. She doesn't.
Esther?
Yes.
An orphan?
Uh-huh. Yes, Mommy. She is.
You don't even need to ask this. Come on. You're welcome to my family.
I have adopted you as my own daughter. That's my mother for you.
Don't do that. Come on, you get up. Please.
Get up, sweetheart.
Mommy, thank you.
God bless you. Thank you.
God bless you too. It's alright. Mommy, thank you. That's my mother for you. She's very kind.
She's so sweet.
I know.
Like you.
Mommy, thank you so much. Thank you.
Like I told you, I want you to eliminate all of them. My sister, her daughter, and even her son, he should be there with them. And also my ex-girlfriend, Esther, she started living there. I'm not going to watch these people take away what I labored for all my life. My money, my properties, no.
Baba, I don't hear everything where you talk. And I don't hear how I want to make you be.
Yes.
No shaking. My problem now, I be say, the money you give us the last time, now less. I just give you testing. You understand? So you go tell me how much you go give me. This is not a big job, they go package. It's in the solve.
Bro, I'm going to give you enough money. In short, I'm going to give you double of what I gave you the last time. Yes.
Not like that?
Yes.
No shaking. I go package her. You know to go tea now.
Yes.
You know how the thing they be.
I believe you, bro.
So no worry yourself.
I believe you, man.
I go run them and it go be clean deal.
Yes, yes.
Don't worry yourself. He bounce.
Okay.
Forget the rest. We had the scores.
All right. Thank you very much.
Tell you bounce.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, eh? Thank you.
All I'm asking is for you to reinstate the old staff. The very good ones your brother laid off. You and I know that he laid them off out of his selfish interest. Because they were trying to hold him accountable and he didn't want that.
Mm-hmm.
At this point, in this company, I think bringing them back will do us a lot of good.
There is sense in what you said. You're absolutely right. But then, how do we get them? We don't have their contacts.
Mom, I have their contacts.
You do?
I have stayed in touch with them.
Now, why don't you call them right away? Come on.
Good. I'm going to call them. That was
What's
a knock.
That?
I don't know. That was a knock, right? I don't. The person is persistent. What?
And why is the person?
Wait, where is.
Do they want to break down the gate?
Are the guards all sleeping or something?
No, person, yes. Who's knocking?
You heard it? No.
Yes.
I'm just wondering. It's late.
I'm just asking my mom the same.
Hey,
My queen.
What happened?
My queen, I was in my room. I heard a knock at the gate. So I went to check. I saw three guys, heavily armed.
Ah!
They are smoking.
Ah!
They are here for a mission.
Jesus.
You don't
say.
Mom, what are we going
to
do? Wait, hold on.
Wait.
Mommy, let me call the police, right?
You have to
call. But we have vigilantes around here, don't we?
Wait. Can you do that fast?
Did you say they are armed?
Please. My God. There might be criminals.
Please don't go out.
Hello? Hello, please, we need help.
We should hurry up now.
We have armed men, like right outside. I think they're criminals. They're trying to gain entrance into our house. In fact, they're breaking in.
Bridget,
please, we need help. Now, please help us. We're so scared.
Bridget, your
voice. Yes, now.
Oh my God.
Please sit.
You're shouting.
Mommy, don't you? Mommy, are they coming inside already? My God.
My queen, I want you both to look at this young man and tell me if you can recognize him. Face them.
Hey, come, let's meet.
No, sorry.
My God. My king!
Daddy!
Igwe!
Daddy!
My king!
Daddy!
My king!
Daddy!
My king!
Daddy!
What happened? My king!
Daddy!
My king!
Daddy!
My king!
Daddy!
My king!
Daddy!
Oh my God!
Oh my God!
My king!
My
king!
My
king! My king! My king! My king! My king! My king!
Mommy.
My king!
Mommy.
My king!
Mom? Wait a minute. I recognize him. Mom, that's him! That's the man that shot at my dad! Mommy, that's him! Look at his face! He's the one! He killed my father!
Yes!
Yes! Mom, that's the man!
God have mercy!
My God.
My daughter is right. This idiot is the person that killed my husband right before me.
Yes, he's the one. And your brother, Mr. Frank, sent them to come and eliminate everyone in the compound last night, which they did.
What, Frank? Yes. Is Frank that bad?
What?
You mean I have been dining with a thief? I mean, a devil all this while?
Hold on! Wait! Hold on. Frank is my brother. Where is officer, please? Criminal! Are you trying to blackmail my brother or what?
I'm not trying to blackmail anybody. Frank was the one that sent me.
Mom, I told you, didn't I? I told you. This man killed my father and now he wants to kill all of us.
Move, officer.
Mom, I told you.
Jesus.
I told you.
I can't believe this. Frank, my brother. Where is my phone? I need to call Frank! Where is my phone? Frank!
I smell trouble. Yes. I think they've been caught. I have to get out of this city before it's too late. I need to get out now. Musa!
Brother, you call me?
My bag's in the car now.
Yes, sir.
Good.
Oga,
you need to get out, all right? You need to get out now. Now, as soon as you can.
Oga, it be like say you dey come out.
Yes.
Oga, what about my salary?
Your salary?
Yes, sir.
Just sit down. I'll bring it for you. Yes. Sit. Sit.
You be like say my guy don't come out here. Ha. And those people don't see you the gate. What am I doing here? Hey, Oga! Oga!
Ichio Obiako. As in evil call Mamia Chuno Diangba. We the elders of Reasonable Kingdom, we're not here for mere child's play. We have come for your son. Bring him out! Bring out your son because we have serious call to settle with him.
And you have only 3 minutes to do that. Yes? I will have one here, Hunanya.
My fellow Ichiers, if I tell you people this, you will not believe me. For the past weeks, I've not set my eyes on this, my very son, you people are asking. I don't know his whereabouts. What he has committed, I don't support him. So I don't know what he's swear about.
So, what you are telling us now is that you don't know where your son is?
Okay, what will be my gain if I hide him from you people? What? Tell me, what will be my gain? You know I don't support him. Oh. Period!
It's okay.
Yes.
You know you are my good friend.
Yes, I do.
I know you as a gentleman. But in this contest, Obiako, listen. Listen good. Okay, you won't ask me. I'm a Iguana. I got in here. Another man claim that cannot dig the ground.
Can you imagine?
You have not seen your son for how many months?
I cannot go back there to confess. They are going to kill me at the end of the day. Please. I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything I did. I'm sorry. I beg you, please don't kill me. No, no. I cannot go back there and confess. They are going to kill me. Please, forgive me. I'm sorry. I cannot.
Okay, I'll go and confess.
Okay, I'll confess.
Okay. I'll confess. I'll go there now. I confess. I promise.
What type of a brother-in-law is this?
I'm going back to the village to confess. I killed him. I caused all the problems. Living life is all he wants. I'm going back to confess.
Money is
I'm going back to the village to confess. Yes. I will confess. I will tell them everything I did. I've done lots of damages. I will confess. I, Frank, will confess. I'm going back to confess.
My fellow elders, since you people say you want to wait and see my son, this is chair. Please, can you sit down?
We are not sitting down. We are here, standing for some hours now, waiting for your son. And yet, he is not here.
As I've told you people before, I've not seen him. I am of the opinion that you will go. Whenever he comes in, I will call you people so that you can.
My elder, are we leaving or we are still waiting for him?
We are not going anywhere. We must see the end of it. I got freely see it, Tata.
I got freely see it. Maka ichokata nchoncho, ichota nchoncho.
We should go where? No, what is it? Why are you men, old men, disturbing my life? What is it? What have I done to you people? What have I done to you people? Why are you sending your four after me? What do you want? What have I done to you? Because why are you disturbing my life?
I killed him. I killed the king.
Yes!
Keep quiet! Let me hear from my son! Keep quiet!
I killed him! Frank! He was wicked!
Frank!
He was mean to me, Papa! I killed him! I sent men to kill him! Yes!
Frank,
I have confessed!
Do you know the implication of what you've just done?
I have confessed! Can you let me be now? Can you let me be now?
Hey!
I have freaking confessed!
Hold on, gentlemen! My fellow chess, hold on. Frank, you killed Igwe, the husband of your elder sister, making her a widow. Hell!
You are cursed already. You killed our king, and you are bold to say it out.
You are not my son. You are not the child I gave birth to. You are not mine. I wash my hand of this matter completely. And listen very well. Whatever music they play for you, get prepared to dance to it.
I have confessed. I will dance the dance. I have confessed.
You must dance.
What else do you want from me? I have confessed.
Asisakinasa.
What are you still doing?
Yes, Asisakinasa.
Okay. What are you old men still doing here? If I go inside and come back to find you, all fools still here, I swear, I'll kill all of you. I swear to God.
Obara Ogun.
Ogun is working. Ogun is working.
Ogun.
Ogun. Ogun. Ogun. Ogun. Ogun. Ogun. Ogun. Ogun.
Ogun. Ogun. Ogun.
You see your life.
Isi ni isi ana.
See your life.
Isi ni isi ana.
Hey. What is going on here?
Look at him. Look at him. Look at him.
What happened?
He has confessed that he killed your father, our king. He killed our king.
And Ogugu dealt with him.
Jesus Christ.
What?
Say Jesus.
Oh.
FK.
I can't believe the good name. 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 Arisi Ogugu, bu ya nwozu ya. It was Ogugu that killed him for the crime and the atrocity he committed in this land.
Hey.
Elders of the land arranged the youth to carry his body to the evil forest. That is where he belonged.
Ichie Pius, go ahead and arrange some boys to come and take him to the forest.
Nisi Rabu no forest.
Hey,
Nisi Kote Bobaya. Nisi Abuja.
Hello. What?
Frank is dead. Ah! Look at how this boy wasted his life. That's his business. Of course, what you sow, you reap. He killed my husband. Look at the way he just died. A young boy that I wanted to help by all means. That's his business. What can I say? If only you're careful. Gentlemen and wonderful ladies, especially to my gentlemen seated here, I want to welcome you especially for honoring my invitation. I mean, considering what happened between you men and I, you people came to open my eyes for me to see the evil my brother has been committing and, you know, in my late husband's company. I didn't see it because I never believed my brother would stoop so low, you know, as in to betray me. I didn't believe it. But I called you people, yet you came to answer my call. So allow me to say that I'm sorry for what transpired that time. I am deeply sorry.
It's okay, ma'am. I sit right here to speak freely from the core part of my heart, body, and soul that I bear no grudges against you. Your brother Frank should be blamed.
Ma, my heart is clear and pure. I don't have any grudges against you. As Mr. Johnson here rightly said, Frank cost the whole 10. I thank God he has been exposed in public.
You know, my daughter here warned me seriously about my brother. But I allowed the love I have for my blood to overshadow me, to close my eyes from seeing the truth. But I'm glad I finally saw the truth. Thank you for forgiving me. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
So let me quickly use this opportunity to beg you men to please go back to the company and occupy your positions. I mean, the company can't even function properly without you men. Believe me.
Oh, thank you very much, ma'am. May God continue to bless you.
Oh, same here.
And I promise you that I will always deliver far better than what I have always done in the past.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome. One more thing. I want to tell you, wonderful men, that I will be joining the company.
Uh-oh.
On Monday, as we resume on Monday, because today is Friday already, so I'll be joining as the managing director of my late husband's company. And my wonderful barrister seated here, my precious daughter, will become the new CEO of my husband's company.
Congratulations. Thank you.
Let me also use this opportunity to tell you that this fair lady, beautiful, seated close to my daughter, is now the new company's chief accountant.
Oh my God.
That's great. That's really, really great. That's a very wonderful selection. But again, ma'am, I call it a formidable team. It simply means that the company will now be moving higher and higher.
You really did a wonderful selection. It's a new development. But ma, what of your son, the prince? And how also that Frank is owing everybody in the company 4 months' salary.
It's all right. Trust me when I tell you, once I resume on Monday, as the managing director, the first thing I would do is to clear every debt that my brother was owing and to pay all my staff the salary. Yes.
Thank you very much.
I will. I will. And as for my son, Prince, well, Prince is doing very well, but you know, he's too young to join the company. That's very true. Much young. He'll be going back to boarding school next week.
Hey, that's fine.
Thank you very much, Mom. Thank you.
Sweetheart, you're not saying anything. Our barrister.
Mommy, there's nothing more to say, okay? You have said it all.
And you, our new accountant, say something. No matter how small.
Mommy, I mean, I'm speechless.
All right.
I'm so happy, I'm grateful. Thank you so much. You have really done enough for me. And thank you for the position in the company. Mm-hmm. Mommy, I'm grateful, thank you.
How many times will you say thank you? You have said it enough. It's all right, you're welcome. So now that all of us are in one spirit, I believe that we all will help to move my late husband's company forward. To God's glory and to the shame of the devil that used my younger brother, Frank. May God forgive him, honestly. So, let's cheers to a new beginning.
Sure.
More success.
Yes, more success.
Hip, 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 hooray!
Thank you very much, Mom.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
I have tried so hard to put up with your excesses, but you seem to be taking advantage of it. You want me to cut ties with someone that has not done anything to me. This person we are talking about is someone I'm going to walk down the aisle with soon. You see this house? You are not living here. And you are not going to like my comeback.
For your sanity and mine, I will advise you to stop coming to my house until everything is completely settled.
My father's throne is lying desolate, and all you keep telling me tonight is that you're not ready, you're not ready, you're not ready.
I mean, this is clearly not about me, it's just about you and the throne.
Why won't you get intimate with my son? Do you know what is at stake because of your selfishness?
You mean your wife has denied you intimacy in the past 1 month?
You'll have to inflict serious pain on her.
I will do the needful and I will use other measures. I do not care if it favors my son or not.
Don't you dare me. Stay away from my sister.
It might not be justifiable enough, but please hear me before killing me, please.
Is that your way of trying to evade death? You two have caused me so much pain.
I am supposed to pay the ultimate price here, please.
Destroy everything.
You are leaving this palace for a more worthy woman.
This should be the very last time I am going to see that idiot in this house.
How dare you disgrace my fiancé? Honestly, love, I feel like tearing you apart right now.
Are you infertile? Is that what you are hiding from your husband that has made you to resist?
Shut up!
And if you must know, I am not ready to carry a child. For now, I need you to stay back home until we rectify this.
Or is it dawn on you that I have a man now and you are still single?
How dare you make such dirty and careless utterance?
I said move!
Put the gun down. Put the gun
down.
Get on the floor, get on the floor, get on the floor, get on the floor.